You say there's no way Charles Manson will be granted parole. Why?
Well, these hearings are just a formality, Anderson. He's had 11 prior hearings, and he knows he's going to be automatically rejected. And the evidence of that is that he hasn't even shown up at some of these hearings. Leslie Van Houten, one of his co-defendants, was only convicted of 2 murders, and the parole board has refused to release her. So why in the world would they ever dream of releasing Charles Manson, who's been convicted of 9 murders? Just convicted of 9 murders, but he's the one that orchestrated and masterminded all of the Manson family killings. So it's ridiculous on its face to assume that there's even a possibility that he's going to be released.
Do you have any doubt that he's still a danger to society?
Yeah, he's still a danger, of course. Of course he is. I think he'd be emboldened if he were ever set free. But even if he were not a danger to society, if justice means anything in America, at a very minimum, he should spend the rest of his life behind bars. Some people forget, Anderson, that Manson originally was sentenced to death. I told the jury that if this was not a proper case for the imposition of the death penalty, no case ever would be. Even challenged them and said that if you're unwilling to come back with a verdict of death in this case, we should abolish the death penalty in California. How many people do you have to kill to get the death penalty? And they did return verdicts of death against him, but as you probably know, Anderson, the very next year in 1972, the California and U.S. Supreme Courts both ruled that the death penalty was unconstitutional.
Does it disappoint you as a former prosecutor that he continues to get attention?
Well, yeah, because I'll tell you, he I think enjoys his notoriety.
He enjoys it.
Steeped in infamy as it is. You know, after my trial or after my trying him and convicting him, he told me, he says, you know, Mr. Bugliosi, you haven't achieved anything at all. All you've done is send me back to where I came from. We used to have sarcastic conversations back and forth, and I said, yes, Charlie, but as far as I know, you've never been to the green room before. That's the Apple Green Room at San Quentin, the gas chamber, and he just smiled. But the next year, I was listening to the radio, and I heard that the Supreme Court, the United States, had set aside the death penalty, and the first thought that came into my mind was what Manson had told me. He gets out of prison in 1967. 32 years of age, 17 out of those 32 years have been spent in jails, reformatories, and prisons. So he doesn't mind prison life. He's totally institutionalized, and all we do is send him back to where he came from, and he doesn't mind it at all. I think he's enjoying himself, and of course, it's just a tremendously gross violation of the entire notion of justice.